Myself, Nilesh Talavia. I'm from Aplex System, basically Surat, and we are in EPC. And right now, I am moderator of this session. And request to all speakers to introduce themselves from Mr. Q. Rakholia.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for this amazing opportunity. And I am K.U. Rakholia from Heaven Solar Energy Private Limited. We provide solar consultancy and engineering services to the solar EPC company. We closely work with more than 80 company in the India and out of the country as well. Handing over to Mr. Shailesh.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. This is Shailesh Vaidya from a company called Scorpius Trackers based in Pune. We make solar trackers. Till date, we have supplied and installed around 500 megawatts of solar trackers in India and a few other countries. And globally have about 15,000 megawatts under bidding right now. It's a pure Indian technology company servicing all kinds of private or government IPP requirements to basically lower the cost of generation of power. Thank you.
Hello, good afternoon everyone. Myself Shantanu Shirsat. I am from Growatt New Technology. Basically, we are the manufacturer of solar grid-tied inverters ranging from 1 kilowatt up to 80 kilowatt. Thank you.
Good afternoon everyone. I am Bhavesh Modi. I am the director of Sunlight Solar Private Limited. We are basically a leading manufacturer of solar PV modules. We also do have an EPC wing which actually does the installation and commissioning of solar PV projects. We do have a residential project team which actually handles like around 25 franchises all over Gujarat through which we are doing the residential 600 megawatt PGV cell project. Thank you.
Hello friends, I'm Vans Pandya from Imagine Power Tree. So basically, we are a manufacturer of solar power trees, and we are saving the land by 90% compared to the normal solar power plants. And we have a various range of power tree with a single capacity, with a single pole. It can install up to 2 kilowatt, up to 25 kilowatt. And we have 17 patents in a different designs of power trees. So thank you.
Good afternoon all. I'm Ankit Patel. I represent my firm Hypotenuse Energy. We are into solar EPC sectors. Our core focus is into industrial and commercial sectors where we provide concept to commissioning solutions for solar photovoltaic plants. We have also participated in solar tenders since past 2 years in the state of Gujarat. Thank you.
Yeah, good afternoon all. Myself Himmat Singh. I am CEO of Photon Technologies Private Limited. We are providing robotic cleaning system for solar power plants. So we are providing both wet and dry cleaning system as per the geographic and dust conditions. Like we have recently launched our product and we have done some pilots and now we are like in the way to launch it commercially. So like our main motto is that we are doing a lot of R&D in there. Like we can provide geography specific, dust condition specific cleaning system throughout the India. Because only when we are talking about dry cleaning system, single system or single cleaning mechanism we can't place in all the Indian geographies because a lot of dust conditions are varying throughout the India. Yeah, thank you.
Hi, good afternoon. This is Gurpreet representing Jinsol Engineering Limited. We are largest consultants for solar in India, having a cumulative portfolio of more than 20 gigawatts consulted till now. That's roughly every second project in the country. We are also largest independent third-party operators with almost 3.5 gigawatts of asset under our management. We also have an organization doing into industrial IoT, and we started with the renewables. So we have very strong, razor-sharp focus on data accumulation. And today on this occasion, we also launched one of our reports, which you can get from Susan, one of my colleagues back there towards end. So it correlates, so we understand data is very important and data has been driving. And somewhere in the rush of optimizing costs, people have forgotten that what wonders data can bring to these projects. There have been consistent cost cuttings on SCADA systems, reducing the cost. People say we can't utilize our string level data. What do I do with these 20,000 data flickering in front of my screen? So there's a lot of sense that you can make out of it. but I think it required some concentrated efforts. So yeah, that's our mission, to keep powering data-driven O&M, data-driven engineering. Gensol also got listed on BSE's SME exchange this year, and the IP was phenomenal, and a lot of people sitting here extended very good support, so thanks for that.
Good afternoon. My name is Vikas Gayakwad. I'm representing Tata BlueScope Steel here. Tata Steel, everybody knows. BlueScope Steel is an Australian conglomerate who are into the value-added steel. We are having a manufacturing plant at Pune, Chennai, Bhiwadi, and Adityapur in East. We are into the supporting structure of solar panel, both in rooftop and ground-mounted. And so far, we have contributed 500 megawatt, solar structure, manufacturing, out of which 40 megawatt, is on the rooftop. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dash. गवर्नमेंट ने जब 2030 तक का रोड मैप कुछ रेडी कर लिया है और इंडस्ट्री ग्रो कर रही है, उस वक्त मेक इन इंडिया भी काफ़ी फोकस पे है गवर्नमेंट के, और उसके ऊपर काफ़ी सारा काम भी हो रहा है। इवन हम अभी DCR में और वो सारी चीज़ों में जा रहे हैं, तब मैं मेक इन इंडिया को ध्यान में रखते हुए मिस्टर मोदी से पूछना चाहूँगा कि मेक इन इंडिया की वजह से सोलर इंडस्ट्री पे क्या इम्पैक्ट आएगा, क्या बेनिफिट मिलेगा। हैंड ओवर टू मिस्टर मोदी।
वेल थैंक यू। सी एक्चुअली दोज ऑलरेडी डूइंग बिजनेस इन गुजरात माइट ऑलरेडी बी फीलिंग द हीट ऑफ अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ DCR सोलर मॉड्यूल्स, राइट। There were two parts. I mean, first we had like Make in India solar PV modules, and now we are trying to get made in India solar cells. The only problem here is the availability of the technology, or we can say the willpower, and the availability of manufacturers. So As we already discussed, I think in morning sessions as well, that the cell manufacturing capacity in India is hardly of, I think, 5 to 10% of that of panel manufacturing facility. So you imagine at like 100 gigawatt against 100 gigawatt of solar panel manufacturing capacity, we have like around 10 or 15 gigawatt solar cells manufacturers. So basically, this is a gap that is creating the increase in prices. All right, then we have some limitations with the availability of DCR modules, like in DCR cells, we have the capacity that is available in market is usually from which we can make 325, 330 watt panels, not higher than that. Like we tried very hard to get the cells of higher efficiency, and we could go around 335 for 10 or 15% cases. So these are basically some of the limitations that comes with our Make in India mission, obviously. And the other thing that I would like to draw attention to is we are seeing a different direction of policies that our government is offering. On one hand, we are asking to, we are having large goals, large targets that we want to achieve. And on the other side, we are putting up of course, quality is of utmost importance. We also understand that, and we should also encourage Make in India. But then at the same time, if you want to implement so many things, we already know this is a gap, these are the limitations. I'm not sure if the policies are created without this, this much detailed study, or how it is happening. It seems that we are implementing the policies as well as doing the work at the same time.
usually we have the policies, then we have guidelines, then we have a set of process to follow that policy, and then we start working. This is happening like we have floated 600 megawatt tender, we have already started work, and then we are asking questions how to do it. So these are the gaps that I think we have when we talk about Make in India mission.
Thank you, Mr. Murthy. मैं श्री शांतनु से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि गवर्नमेंट की एंटी डंपिंग ड्यूटी और सेफगार्ड ड्यूटी जो है उसकी वजह से व्हेन ग्रोवर्ट इज ग्लोबल ग्लोबल मैन्युफैक्चरर तो एंटी डंपिंग और सेफगार्ड ड्यूटी की वजह से सोलर इंडस्ट्री को क्या पाथ मिल रहा है.
So basically, we are the manufacturers of grid-tied inverters. So right now for inverters, that particular concept of anti-dumping is not yet implemented. So but in future, if you see, the Indian market is totally driven by the Chinese manufacturers in case of at least the inverters. So if this type of policy is implemented, obviously it is going to hamper the total solar policies or the this particular market. So I think that for inverters, at least till we don't have in-house manufacturing setup for all the solar grid-tied inverters, I am little bit doubtful that this particular anti-dumping would be applicable for grid-tied inverters.
Thank you. We have EPC partner here, and want to ask them important of quality about plant operation and maintenance. I request Mr. Himmat Singh, please say something on operation maintenance upcoming technologies.
Yes, sir. So like I'm listening since morning that there are a lot of guidelines and policies for the solar power plants installations and selecting the components, these all. In the upcoming technology in O&M, there's one thing we don't have any policy, any guideline yet. There are a lot of, like there are some robotic cleaning company even, there are a lot of new inspection techniques are there in market, but there's no guideline for them as of now. Recently we are happy that last 3 months, MNRE launched, like I did some guidelines that EPC company and the solar developer plans should use a robotic cleaning system or some system which use less water. So that is the only one line we got from the government policy or agencies, we can say. So there is no policy and guideline as of now, I will say. And if I talk about latest technology which are coming in the O&M sector, yeah, there are some technologies coming. If we, if I put my point in the major O&M required in the solar power plant, first is the cleaning, second is the inspection, and third thing is like changing the component and like managing these assets, like when we need to change it, and how to change it efficiently and effectively. So particularly in cleaning, if I say, there are some companies which are working since last four years in India. They are not effective, first of all, because of like India is a big country with lot of various dust conditions in each and every geography. And like even we are doing the R&D yet on these things only. Second thing is that like in inspection, there are some companies who are doing work. We don't have guideline for them even. Like their inspection report is suitable and like working correct and where like the inspection report is not suitable for what kind of plant and what kind of actions not guided yet. And there are some more techniques which are coming in the energy management. Like Gurpreet recently told, like we have a lot of data, we don't know how to understand it. In O&M even, like how to get it key when plants are not working properly. So there are some companies who are working this thing even. Even I think Gensol Group have one kind of project in this. So they are analyzing the data and telling like when plant is working, how, what is the efficiency, what is the performance, these things. Yeah, so I would say like this.
Thank you, sir.
Excuse me. I would like to add a few words on what Mr. Singh said. For example, upcoming technology, if we talk about, let us take the sector of inspection, visual inspection of these solar plants. So like what Mr. Singh said, government doesn't have any policies for visual inspections if we do it through drones. Now, this drone is a very interesting technology through which we can inspect our modules, our the entire plant, and there are other important, what I say, equipment which inspects thermally as well. So they provide thermal inspection also, so that if you are the monitor of the entire plant, you will be able to know that, okay, these are the area where the hotspot, which Mr. The presenter has recently mentioned, that there are hotspot in the panel which you cannot see visually, but if you have the thermal images, you will be able to see them. So these are the upcoming technologies, and government should seriously consider them. Another thing is that, let us say, if we have plants located on the border, and if we are sharing the border with the neighbor countries, and if we operate drones, there are a lot of restrictions and there are a lot of national level threats and concerns which we have. So government should also think in this area as well. Thanks.
Thank you. Plant operation and performance के लिए मैं EPC Mr. अंकित से पूछना चाहूँगा, कहना चाहूँगा कि प्लीज आप इम्पोर्टेंट जो है इक्विपमेंट का, उसके बारे में आप कुछ बात शेयर करें.
देखिए, बात ऐसी है कि अगर कुछ भी करना है तो क्वालिटी इज़ अ मस्ट थिंग. अगर कोई भी चीज़ है, बी इट अ सोलर प्लांट, थर्मल प्लांट, न्यूक्लियर प्लांट, हाइड्रो प्लांट, एनीथिंग, इफ़ यू डोंट हैव द क्वालिटी, इट विल नॉट वर्क. Maybe 2 years, 3 years, 5 years down the line, it will definitely fall. So when we select the equipment in solar plant, see, solar plant comes with a lot of equipment, solar panel, inverters, cables, structure, nut bolts, fasteners, anchors, everything. Agar uske andar agar hum log quality ko priority nahi de payenge, to plant probably 3 saal, 4 saal, 5 saal tak chalega. Later on, we'll face issues. Now, this is the energy generating business, where we generate electricity from the sunlight, right? There are potential risk involved. Kabhi kuch cases mein fire ho sakta hai, kabhi short circuit ho sakta hai. If we don't select the equipment which comply to the standards, international standards, and the government's policy, you will not be able to tackle these kind of issues later on. So if I talk about the performance of the plant, there are panels coming with different efficiency ratios, like 16%, 17%. If you go for higher efficiency, higher generating, higher rating plant panels, like 370 watts, 385 watts, so same dimension mein aapko zyada generation mil raha hai. That means the efficiency is little bit higher. So mera hamesha yahi approach rehta hai in selecting the equipment, that let us go for the good quality material. Let's go for the good quality equipment. Inverters, we have a lot of inverters available. But if you select the cheap inverter, there must be something which is not available in this inverter. And the better companies, the bigger companies, the bankable companies have in their own products. So yes, quality does matter in this case. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Ankit. जब हम बात कर रहे हैं performance की, तो performance के अंदर जब प्लांट डिज़ाइन हो रहा है तो उसको काफ़ी मायने रखता है, डिज़ाइनिंग एंड इंजीनियरिंग काफ़ी मायने रखता है. तो मैं डिज़ाइनिंग के एक्सपर्ट मिस्टर केयूर से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि आप ऑपरेशन एंड परफॉर्मेंस के ऊपर डिज़ाइनिंग के वक्त क्या चीज़ें ध्यान रहती है और उसका बेनिफिट क्या होता है ओवर एंड प्लांट को, उसके बारे में आप कुछ बताइए.
थैंक यू. एक्चुअली हम बहुत सारे EPC के साथ काम करते हैं. अभी जनरल जो मार्केट में प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है, जिस तरह से क्लाइमेट चेंज जितनी जल्दी हो रहा है, उतनी जल्दी हम सोलर प्रोजेक्ट नहीं कर रहे. तो मेजर इश्यू कहाँ पे आ रहा है कि एंड कस्टमर है, उनको लो कॉस्ट सॉल्यूशन चाहिए, और जो EPC प्लेयर है उनको मैक्सिमम मार्जिन चाहिए. तो और EPC प्लेयर और भी मार्केट में अभी आ रहे हैं नए नए, तो थ्रोट कटिंग कॉम्पिटिशन एक तरह से चल रही है. ऊपर से थोड़ी गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसी की रेगुलेशंस की इश्यू चल रही है. तो जब ऐसी कंडीशन में कोई बड़ा प्रोजेक्ट लग जाता है, 200 किलोवाट, 500 किलोवाट का प्रोजेक्ट, जहाँ पे प्रॉपर डिज़ाइन इंजीनियरिंग कंसल्टेंसी के बिना प्रोजेक्ट लग जाता है, तब होता यह है कि जो एक्सपेक्टेड रिटर्न आना चाहिए, जो एक्सपेक्टेड ROI होना चाहिए उसका, उतना होता नहीं. और क्योंकि जनरेशन जो जहाँ पे 5 यूनिट, 4 यूनिट पर डे पर किलोवाट आना चाहिए, उसकी वजह से वो 2 यूनिट या फिर 2.5 यूनिट के आसपास आता है. तो अभी हमने सारी, जैसे क्वालिटी की बात हुई हमारी, कि क्वालिटी कंपोनेंट सिलेक्ट करते हैं, क्वालिटी सोलर पैनल सिलेक्ट करते हैं, जहाँ पे उनकी बैक सीट का भी बहुत सारा इंपॉर्टेंस है, बहुत सारे कंपोनेंट्स हम बेस्ट सिलेक्ट करते हैं, लेकिन जब प्रोजेक्ट अच्छे से एग्जीक्यूट नहीं होगा कि सोलर इन्वर्टर को कितने वोल्टेज चाहिए, कितनी एफिशिएंसी पे वो वर्क करेगा, फर्स्ट ईयर का क्या डिग्रेडेशन होगा पैनल का, अगर वहाँ पे जब क्वालिटी वहाँ जब डिजाइन साइड कंट्रोल डिजाइन साइड क्वालिटी कंट्रोल हो जाएगा तब जाके प्लांट अच्छे से परफॉर्म नहीं कर पाएगा। फर्स्ट ईयर तो अच्छा परफॉर्म हो जाएगा लेकिन जब फर्स्ट ईयर सबसे ज़्यादा डिग्रेडेशन होता है 2.7% के आसपास आई थिंक, और सो डिज़ाइन साइड जब फॉलो नहीं होता तब बड़े प्रोजेक्ट्स परफॉर्मेंस अच्छा नहीं कर पाते, 2.5 यूनिट पर डे जब जनरेट करता है तब क्लाइंट को सोलर इंडस्ट्री जो एंड कस्टमर है जिसने इसके अंदर इन्वेस्टमेंट किया है जिनको इतना एक्सपेक्टेशन होता है कि एटलीस्ट मैं 25% या 22% जितना रिटर्न ले पाऊंगा, तो उनका जो विश्वास रहता है सोलर इंडस्ट्री से वो मतलब वो इतना कॉन्फिडेंट नहीं रहते आगे इन्वेस्ट करने के लिए। तो प्राइस और गवर्नमेंट रेगुलेशंस और काफ़ी सारी चीज़ों की वजह से ये भी कई बार हो जाता है कि क्वालिटी कंप्रोमाइज, प्रोडक्ट अच्छे होने के बाद भी पावर प्लांट अच्छा परफॉर्म नहीं कर पाता। तो ज़्यादातर ईपीसी को जब ऐसी प्रॉब्लम्स आती है तब वो फिर से ओएनएम या फिर से डिजाइनिंग करके फिर से पूरा प्रोजेक्ट को रिवाइज करते। तो यही रहता है कि सबसे पहले तो एक जैसे ईपीसी का मतलब ही होता है कि इंजीनियरिंग प्रोक्योरमेंट एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन, तो ई के ऊपर भी थोड़ा फोकस किया जाए।
थैंक यू मिस्टर केयूर।